Welcome. In this lecture, you will learn about the necessary components of an industrialized approach to the refurbishment of houses in the Groningen area. The built environment is an integral part of our daily lives, and buildings are an important part of our living environment. The way buildings are developed is a fascinating process, and since the final result is so important, a sophisticated process is essential. For every building, a project organization is arranged, with a large number of experts like architects, engineers, and builders. Their aim is then to fabricate a product that meets the demands of the user, but certainly also of the surrounding area and society. In short, building is a complex task. Sometimes there are mixed feelings about projects. Expectations of a project are high, the end result is fantastic, but there's also criticism. This building, for instance, is widely glorified because of its groundbreaking architecture and the advanced building techniques that were used, especially for that time. It opened in 1973. It's also a project that has cost much more and has taken much longer to build than planned. The project realization of the remarkable design was much more intricate than expected. Project-oriented working makes it possible to take the specifics of the location and the wishes of the client into account. But there are also disadvantages, because a new project organization has to be put together every time, and it's hard to apply all available knowledge and experience from the past. Another disadvantage is that participants in the project have to get used to each other every time. Specific agreements have to be made and processes aligned. This can lead to tuning problems, which loss of quality and extra cost as a result, which in jargon we call failure costs. One could ask if all building projects should be undertaken in a project-oriented way. Are all buildings or parts of them actually that unique? Often, and certainly when building and renovation dwellings, a lot of repetition occurs. A lot of parts like foundation, floors and roof structures are the same every time. In those cases, an industrialized way of working is much more obvious, not only with new built houses, but also when restoring or renovating dwellings, like in the earthquake area. It's important to consider what type of organization or process is best for strengthening existing houses in an earthquake-prone area. A project-oriented approach makes it possible to create specific solutions, but has the disadvantages of limited learning effects and skill advantages. It's important to choose a form of organization in which residents, public authorities and specialists like architects and engineers, contractors and suppliers work together strategically. A collaboration that makes it possible to apply good construction solutions in an effective and efficient way. A collaboration in which partners learn from each other, share information and knowledge, and strive to constantly improve solutions. What would an approach like that look in an earthquake area? I think that it consists of three interconnected components: a strategic public-private collaboration, standardized technical solutions, and an integrated process. The first component, setting up a strategic collaboration in the area, demands the unification of interests of residents, public authorities and building companies. This kind of collaboration will lead to the sharing of knowledge on dwelling improvement and the integration of various aspects. In the case of Groningen, these motives are clearly present, making it possible that the standardized solutions are brought about with the integration of the demands and wishes of the occupants. The fact that the issues at hand are local, combined with a large building volume, is an important reason to work together. At present, several collaborations have been established in the area, such as the Nationaal Coördinator Groningen and Centrum Veilig Wonen. The challenge in the earthquake area is to achieve efficiency and synergy. Standardization, the second component in our framework, can help with that. Standardization brings advantages in quality and logistics. A good quality result can be achieved within a short time. Furthermore, it offers the opportunity to tackle several goals of the renovation, such as reinforcement, raising comfort and sustainability, integrally. The industrial approach, the combination of improvements in one technical solution and higher production numbers, make for lower costs and higher value for occupants. In short, a better price to quality ratio. An organizational question that needs to be answered is what type of reinforcement or sustainability measures fit with each type of house. The last component of the proposed approach is the creation of an integrated process. By integrating the entire chain, all work building activities are geared to one another. This is supported by modern information technology, using so-called building information models, which can register exactly which building activities are needed in what house and which standardized solution should be applied. Reinforcing and modernizing houses in the earthquake area is a complex task. Combining necessary improvements to make the houses earthquake resistant together with other possible improvements, like energy efficiency, is not simple. Collaboration, standardization and integration are important principles to tackle this challenging assignment for an industrialized approach to the refurbishment of houses in the Groningen area. Thank you.